This is how to deal with diprotic acids. Succinic acid is a diprotic acid often used to regulate acidity in beverages and food, and it's within our own bodies as part of the citric acid cycle. Calculate the pH and concentrations of all species, given Ka1 is 6.9 times 10 to the minus 5, and Ka2 is 2.5 times 10 to the minus 6. Okay, what do these Ka's actually refer to? Well, they refer to deprotonation one at a time. So my first reaction is H2, and I guess I'll just write SUC for succinic acid. And the definition acid Ka reaction is an acid relative in strength to water makes conjugate base, which usually has a minus charge, plus hydronium. That first Ka of 6.9 times 10 to the minus 5 refers to this reaction. And a little ways down, I'm going to write the second reaction because I need room to do a few things here. But the second reaction is we take HSUC minus, which was our product in the first reaction, and react it with another water in equilibrium to produce SUC succinate, 2 minus now, plus hydronium. And the Ka for this reaction is known as Ka2. That's equal to 2.5 times 10 to the minus 6. Okay, now getting around to all species in the reaction. Oh, you weren't given an initial concentration. Shall we say that the concentration of the original acid is 0.50 molar. Let's add that to our question. It's a little hard to do it without a concentration. Okay, so our acid we're going to say starts at 0.50 molar. Very well, we shall write an equilibrium table. 0.50 is where we start with nothing and nothing. That's our initial. Our delta is minus x here, plus x here, and plus x here. And our final is 0.50 minus x, x, and x. Okay, I don't have very much room, and you've done enough of these, that I'm hoping you're going to let me just say Ka is products over reactants raised to their coefficients. So that would be x times x over 0.50 minus x. And that turns out to be equal to 6.9 times 10 to the minus 5. Now, in my particular case, I am betting that x is going to be negligible compared to the 0.5 concentration. But you and your homework have a higher value of K1, so I'm not sure I would make that assumption in your case. I might pull out the quadratic. But in my case, I'm allowed to say x squared is equal to 0.50. times 6.9 times 10 to the minus 5, and solve for x. My x turns out to be equal to 0.0059 molar. And don't forget what that represents. It represents the concentration of succinate and hydronium. So, I am going to actually write that for myself specifically right here, okay, so that I remember that. And for my original H2 succinate, I have to subtract 0.0059, which rounds up to 0.01. So technically, when I do the subtraction, this is 0.49 molar. Okay, so I've got some concentrations, but what about the second reaction? All right, well, let's think about this. My H succinate concentration is The same one I calculated in the first reaction, 0.0059 molar. Water, I'm not going to worry about. I haven't deprotonated yet, but here's what's different about the second reaction. I have hydronium from the first reaction, and the amount I have is 0.0059 molar. So when I write my delta table of minus x here, plus x, and plus x, my final rows for here will be 0.0059 minus x, x, and 0.0059 plus x. Once again, I must set this equal to the equilibrium constant. So that will be x times 0.0059 plus x, rather, over 0.0059 minus x. And that should be equal to the Ka2, which is 2.5 times 10 to the minus 6. Okay. Once again, I'm going to make an assumption that x is negligible when it's added or subtracted to a larger value. Then I'm left with x times 0.0059 over 0.0059, which is kind of like x times 1 divided by 1. So when I simplify this, x is equal to 2.5 times 10 to the minus 6. And certainly my suggestion that it's negligible is correct, because 0.0059 minus 2.5 times 10 to the minus 6 is still equal to 0.0059. Okay, so now to outline what are the answers to my questions, okay? The concentrations of all species, H2 succinate, is going to be equal to the value from the first equilibrium table, 0.49 molar. My H succinate, deprotonated once, is going to be equal to 0.0059 molar. My hydronium is also going to be equal to 0.0059 molar. And finally, the completely deprotonated material is going to be equal to 2.5 times 10 to the minus 6 molar. The last thing I need to do is the pH. The pH, as you know, is the negative log of the hydronium. So that would be equal to, oops, I lost the negative sign. There we go. The negative log of 0.0059, which when I put it in my calculator, turns out to be equal to 2.23. All right, well, that's how you deal with a diprotic acid.